Hi everybody, welcome back to my last video for the year 2020. I know I have been absent a lot this year, but I'm going to talk a little bit about that in today's video. But today I wanted to share with you guys what 2020 was to me, what lessons I learned, and what I'm looking forward to in 2021. I asked you guys if you had any questions for me over on Instagram, so I'm going to answer some of those as well. But let's get started really quickly with a recap of 2020, if you will. Okay, so we're going to do this kind of quickly. So I'm sure a lot of you have watched my other videos or have seen on Instagram kind of different parts of my journey, but I wanted to share the biggest parts with you guys today. Also, it is New Year's Eve right now, and I had filmed this yesterday, but the sound was bad. So I'm refilming and re-editing and hoping to have this up on December 31st. Okay, so in January 2020, I was actually in a really, really dark place. If you guys remember, or if you're new or whatever, I had injured my back in October of 2019. So my back was still healing. I couldn't do a lot of workouts, so I was doing a lot of Pilates, reformer machine and yoga, just really taking it easy. I was in a really bad place in my personal life as well, with some relationships in my life. It was a dark time, guys. It was winter. I had gained a lot of weight. I was eating a lot of my feelings, and I just was not in a great place. But I chose the word rise for my word of 2020, and I wanted to rise above all of that, above my injuries, above the things that were stressing me out, just above everything. And that was my goal for the year of 2020. As you know, March was crazy for the entire world, especially for the United States, because that's when everything kind of shut down. My birthday was March 7th. Brad's birthday was March 9th. The day after Brad's birthday, he was laid off from his job. And then the twins had a birthday on the 11th. And then the 13th, I believe, was the day that the entire country shut down. So it was stressful, as you can imagine, trying to find a job during a pandemic, just like out of left field. And I mean, that's just life, I guess, you know. And I strangely felt comfortable and confident because I know Brad's abilities. He has such great experience. He's such a hard worker, and he was laid off, and I knew that he would find something. And it was scary, but he found a job. He found an incredible job, and he is still there, loving life. We were supposed to go on a trip to London and Paris in March. Obviously that didn't happen, so that was canceled. And we have spent the entire year of 2020 zero traveling. And it's been hard for me mentally, you guys. I love to travel. You guys know that if you follow me. It's one of the things that keeps me sane. I love visiting places, but obviously we knew that that wasn't gonna happen this year. So I knew we had a choice. Once the school shut down and once we were quarantined and everything, I knew that I had to step it up. I needed to keep a positive outlook for my kids and for my family and for my husband and for my friends, just trying to hope for the best and hope that we could ride this out. One of the biggest things that I fell in love with in 2020 was cycling, road cycling on my bike, and also mountain biking, of course, but more so road cycling at first. I spent so many hours on the trails, and I rode hundreds and hundreds of miles because it was a quarantine-friendly activity. We could go outside and ride the bike and be outside in the beautiful weather here in Utah and go up to the mountains. And my friend Sarah and I went on so many rides together, and our longest ride was a 50-miler. And we just go every Saturday morning for a few hours. And I would go probably 5 times a week, every day. It was like an addiction to me. I loved pushing myself, and I didn't feel like I was getting injured in the way that I would when I would run. And I felt like my body could take that impact a lot easier. And it was just fun, just very therapeutic, a lot of praying, a lot of thinking, and, you know, just really trying to figure out who I was. I feel like I was very lonely at the beginning of this year in my personal life, and I was just doing a lot of soul searching, essentially. And whew, then July hit, and I decided to work with a nutritionist, and I've talked about that before, so I don't have to go into all the details of that, but I had a really bad relationship with food, and it was like a drug to me in the sense of I would use it to medicate myself. And especially after my back injury in 2019 and all the things that I was going through, I was eating at my feelings, and I knew I needed to have somebody hold my hand and guide me through that. So working with Trish changed my life in that sense, and she always tells me, like, you did it though. Like, I told you what to do, but you did it. And you know what? I did do it. I was very, very disciplined, and I learned so much about health and nutrition, and I haven't worked with her now for about 3-4 months, and I'm doing great. I'm living my life, and I feel like I don't need somebody to hold my hand because I'm very well aware, and she gave me the tools that I can use now to help me live a healthy life. And that was one of the biggest things, was I wanted to be healthy for my kids. And as I get older, I'm, you know, going to turn 37 here, I'm not getting younger, so I want to be able to be active, and it was so fun to cycle with Brad, and he got me into mountain biking as well. And I actually, in September, I got in a really bad mountain biking accident, if you guys remember, and got a really bad concussion, and that was really scary, so I couldn't ride my bike for a few months after that. So cycling was one thing that kept me sane during this time, and I love and I cherish those months where it was just my family and I in our house. It was such a special time. It was really stressful with the schooling and everything, but once that was over, I just felt, wow, when else can I have this precious time to be with my children? And all activities are canceled. We literally are not allowed to see anyone or be anywhere. We have nowhere to be except with each other. Like, what a blessing that is. And man, it's been such a crazy year in that sense, but I also just feel like my relationships and my life have all improved tenfold. And I know a lot of you have messaged me. It's really weeded out the things that aren't important. And I think when I look back on 2020, I can say the entire year just taught me what was important in life. And we think social media is important. We think friends or status or whatever it is important. And we're spending so much time stressing about holidays and all these things. But I feel like 2020 just stripped away everything. All the fluff. And I feel like that in my personal life with my relationships. Oh man, I just feel so blessed. I feel like I've gotten closer to Brad, I've gotten closer to my kids, to my family, my siblings, and to some of my incredible friends. Wow, I feel very blessed to have the people in my life that I have. And it's just been, it's been a year, hasn't it, to really teach us those things. Also, I believe it was in July, there was a massive fire on the hillside that I live on the mountain that I live on, and it was just two streets up and almost burned down our entire neighborhood. And we were actually gone that night. We were camping, and we literally thought our whole house was going to be burned when we got home. Once again, I was reminded what was really important. I remember sitting there with Brad in our tent thinking, we have nothing to go back for. We have what we need. We have our kids. That's all we need. I don't need anything material. I don't need anything. And we also had an earthquake in Utah as well. So just all these things keep happening to teach me. I feel like it was just God's way of teaching me. Michelle, just remember what's really important. Remember this year. Don't forget what you've learned and what you've felt this year. So once I really started taking care of my health, because I feel like I had time to, we weren't going all these places or on vacations or anything like that. I really got the time to focus on me and healing myself and my relationship with food and my relationship with other people. And I just fell in love with myself. I know that sounds kind of weird to say, but I really did. I really wanted to, the more I took care of myself, the more I realized, wow, I really was not taking care of this one body that I have. I have one life. I have one body. Why am I not taking care of it better? And I was able to do that this year. I wanted to answer some of the questions that you guys asked me. Any advice for keeping friends during hard times, during the pandemic? Definitely weed out the people that are too much work. If somebody's too much work, it's not real, right? I just feel like we don't have that much time in our lives to focus on things that truly bring us down, right? So for me, keeping in touch with my friends was really crucial. So whether that's the Marco Polo app, I love the audio message feature on my iPhone where I don't have to like text it. I just like talk into my phone. That's been really great. Obviously FaceTime, just keep in touch and just don't put pressure on them or pressure on you. We're all going through a hard time. And I think that's what's so great about when you find those real people in your life that are going to be there for you through thick and thin. There doesn't have to be any set of rules of how often you're in contact or anything like that, because you know that you'll always be there for each other. Things you did to keep your sanity during quarantine. I had to have a routine. I made a routine for my kids, even though we weren't going anywhere. I made a daily routine for them to check things off. So every day they had a list of things to do. I had a list of things to do every single day. And for me, routine just does everything. And working out, obviously. What K-dramas did you love this year? I love this question. You guys know I love K-dramas on Netflix. Startup was hands down my favorite K-drama that I watched this year was Startup. I even got my mom a, if you've watched the show, I got her a sweatshirt. It was just really funny. She loved it. Can you sing a song? Love that year you sang this Taylor Swift one. Oh, I have to post that today, actually. How did you find the motivation to get into shape? I was so unhappy and I did not recognize myself in pictures. And honestly, one of the reasons why I stopped vlogging too, I just did not feel like myself. And I have always, always made it my priority to be as real and as authentic with you guys here on YouTube always. And so I didn't feel like getting on here and being fake and putting on a fake happy smiley face and telling you guys to be happy, because I was really searching and I was really trying to figure out who I was. So that was also why I just took a huge break off of YouTube this year. I seriously made 1/50th of how many videos I normally make, if you didn't notice. But that was really crucial for me. I really wanted to focus on myself and on my family. What things did you start doing during the pandemic that you'll continue when this is over? Definitely cycling and definitely just really cherishing the people in my life, my kids, my husband, and the friends and family that I have that have really been there for me. That's something that the people that I've been close to this year will just stay close to me for the rest of my life, because like, we got through a hard time together, you know? What's one thing you learned about marriage or yourself that you didn't know before? That I would say with marriage, that I don't mean this like in a braggart way or anything, but I just realized how strong our marriage really was, that we could go through job loss in a pandemic and we could still always support each other and be there for each other, and Brad just would do whatever it takes to support us and take care of us. But I also learned that I was also willing to do that, and I'm really excited because I've been working on a project, on a brand that I will hopefully be releasing next year, and it's taking a long time. These things take a long time, so I really hope that that's something that can happen. I'm not gonna say hope, it will happen in 2021. It's been something I've been working on and Brad's helping me. It's gonna be really fun, so stay tuned for that. So basically that's it. I think I'm running out of time here. You guys, 2020 was a hard year for all of us, but I really love you and I really appreciate you for sticking around. I know I haven't been the best on here, but I'm honestly honored that you guys follow me and that you interact with me, and I still can't believe my comments are turned off. It's been like 3 years now, but please forgive me. This is not something I have done. It's YouTube. I don't know why they're doing that, but thank you for sticking around. I'm really excited to share 2021 with you guys. Hopefully I'll be doing a lot more content. And I want you guys to share with me over on Instagram what goals you have for 2021. As you know, I am going to share that here as well. I do that every single year. And next year is my 10-year anniversary on YouTube, so I'm really excited for that. So have a great New Year's, and we will see you guys in 2021. Bye.